Shabbat Shalom, everybody.
Shabbat Shalom.
Welcome to Ruach Adonai. Welcome, welcome, welcome. The Spirit of God. I'm Dr. Barry Pratt, and this is my lovely wife, Fran. We co-pastor Ruach Adonai in Thousand Palms, California. We meet every Friday night at 7 p.m. at Desert Christian Community Church.
I'd like to give a shout out to Mitch. It's been a trial, not just for Mitch, but also for Connie. And it seems one thing after another keeps happening. And so we need to keep praying for him. He's going to be going this week. You know, he cracked a vertebra in his back, so he's been in a lot of pain. And he's going this week. I guess they can put what she called cement in that crack to relieve some of the pain. And so let's keep Mitch and Connie. This is a trial for Connie as well, going through this with him. And so just keep Mitch in your prayers. Also, Sandy is back! Sandy is back! The house! Rising from the dead. We're so happy to have her back. Oh my gosh, and you're going to hear her story and how it's affected her life. Lots and lots of prayers went up all around the country, and they worked. Praise the Lord, they worked. She's here with us to tell her story. How wonderful that is. A friend of ours in Minnesota, their son is having a psychotic break, and until the medicine takes effect, he's hearing voices, and so let's just pray that God gives him a healing touch. So for you out there, Josiah, I pray that the Lord heals you. I pray that he shuts those voices up that you're hearing, and that you'll be able to hear just his voice, Lord. A healing, healing touch for Josiah. He was doing so well for so many years, and this is hard. Any of you parents that, you know, you have a struggle like that, it's hard for the parents as well to go through it with the kids. So we just lift up Barbara and Josiah, and we pray for calm, peace, calm his mind down, and give him peace on the Shabbat. And also, we continue to ask you for prayers for our family. It continues on. And so they're having mediation this Wednesday, Brandy and her ex. And I just pray for peace. I pray for shalom. I pray that they can co-parent and stop the nonsense. Just stop the nonsense, the name calling, or, you know, denigration and all the stuff that goes along with that. So, and we pray for our grandchildren because they're the true victims. We pray for our grandchildren that they will get through this with no ash on them, that God will give them beauty, beauty, and roses for ash. Amen. Amen. And I guess, yes, did you have a
little desire that I've done it?
Wait, hold on.
Little Josiah got hit on the head by a golf ball during the golf lesson.
Oh my goodness. Josiah, our little bar mitzvah boy, was hit in the head with a golf ball while taking a golf lesson. How is he doing? He's going to be okay? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Have your hand on that little guy. What a guy. I'm going to miss him sitting here next to me today. So thank you for that update on Josiah. And I guess, anybody else have any prayer requests? Yes.
My friend Lou Silva, he's shoemaker here, and he's a mighty man of God. He's in his 80s, and he's had a second surgery, and they have to put a cage in him inside of him. I don't know what that's all about, but he wasn't doing very well. As of the last report, he's very, very ill, and we need a miracle. Lou Silva, he's a Buddhist. He's got, he used to be in movies long ago. Yeah, very, very well known.
I should mention you. Well, just like the Lord healed her, brought her back to life, he can also do that for your friend, right? Amen? He doesn't favor man. What he does for one, he can do for another. So we pray for God's will to be done. Amen?
Amen.
Thank you. Okay, anybody else?
Yes.
Hi, Walter.
Shabbat shalom. Nice to be here, friends. Well, I just want to share with you a short testimony. My daughter moved out. She's at the Harrison House, which is a wonderful prayer to answer. So she gets a lot of support. She gets free rent, and it's a lot of support for her. My son went to a treatment center. You guys prayed for him during Thanksgiving. He already relapsed. He got caught again. He got suspended. He's going to be expelled. I had the meeting. My prayer is that they heard me and asking for long-term treatment. He needs to get to the root of his substance abuse. So I'm going Tuesday back to the board. I'm going to share just a minute and ask them to consider my request, consider, you know, that I'm a single mom and I've done everything I can to help my son. So he's at home now. He's sober for like a week right now. But I have no tolerance for anything, even if it is pot. No, 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 right? You want a clean and sober, single-minded, according to James. You don't want double-mindedness. So that's what I'm declaring for my son.
Thank you for that update. We've got a wonderful testimony. Amy, a couple weeks ago, her son, after being sober for a year, fell off, you know, was lonely. You know, he'd been going to church, Bible study, carrying his Bible all around, and he really was on track. And then he went off. He got mad about something in the family, causing his sister and me to part company. Then he was out on the street doing strong drugs. He met up with an old drug buddy, his old girlfriend, he was lonely. And we prayed, we lifted him up, and we said, Lord, surround him with the church people, lift him up and put him back on track, right? And so as of today, he's been sober for, what, 3 weeks now? 2 weeks? He relapsed again. Okay, well, we have two sons here that we need to pray. Father God, we hold them in your hands, Lord, and we just pray that the enemy will be thwarted with his plan to destroy them with drugs, Father, that they will be saved and they will have a testimony, unbelievable testimony. So we pray for these two mothers. I can feel your hearts, how sad it is. And we know this is just a comma in their lives. This is not a period. This is just a comma. This is not the end of the story. And we speak life over them. Life over them. Thank you, Father. Use them. Use this testimony, Father. We praise you and thank you. And we leave it at the altar. We leave it at the altar for you, Father. So please, give these mothers peace during the Shabbat and just surround them. Surround them. We're sending out your guardian angels to surround them, to keep them out of any harm, to bodily harm, and to undo all the things that drugs have done to their bodies. Lord, wash them clean. Wash them clean. As if they never were, as if they never had this problem. Amen. Thank you. Did you have a prayer request? Yes.
Yeah, I have one. Okay, I have a prayer request. Tomorrow, my mom and I go to a protest at the picnic, and we're praying for protection and words to say and stand for Jesus.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Jesus,
right?
Good.
Good
prayer.
Did you have one,
Rob? Roy has one, too.
Yeah, and it's my to have my mom be in prayer. And I have a really slow to but still, she had ongoing dementia and was that terribly important. She was in the hospital with a broken femur when there was a situation that we didn't know about. She was triggered with this. And when she's going from that right now, I'm just leaving a baby. I want to remind you guys to pray with me that she would get her appetite back, because her appetite decreased below 10%. And so we're very concerned in order to get her to the next phase of her meal. Building the facility, she has a
sustenance.
And for family unity and for this work, it's been quite a challenge.
It's quite a walk, right around, quite a walk. So, Lord, we just ask that you sustain her through this period, that she needs to heal. It's not her mind, but we would ask for that as well. Nothing is beyond you, but her body, she needs food to eat, Father. And so as the family walks her at the end of this rope into eternity, we just ask that there be no more breaks, that her body doesn't have to be tormented to get there, and that she would heal and be able to walk again, possibly. And Father, we just ask that she would take nourishment, feed not only her body, but her spirit, her soul, because that spirit is still alive. That spirit in her, she may not be able to express herself, but her spirit is still well and healthy. Amen. So we just pray for, what's her name?
Connie.
Okay, Connie, we got your back. We got your back. Okay. Roy?
We got a lot of
They're all needed. I just wanted to bring up a couple of things. I just want to praise God that I was able to keep sane tonight and keep a level head. I was rushing around at the speed of light to get everything going. And please also pray for me that I would be more organized, because I need to be more organized. There are bigger things happening beyond Ruach Adonai congregation, and I'm going to need to be more organized than this. Prayers for me, please.
Okay. Thank you. Well, we pray for you for a job, and a job is on the horizon where he'd be filming opening of restaurants and go to Hawaii with this gentleman that owns restaurants and wants to open up some more restaurants, not only when he closes down Hawaii, but in Arizona and Texas, so you can be a traveling man. So Father, he needs to get organized, Lord. Give him a plan. Give him a plan of action, Father God, in order to get himself prepared for this wonderful job that just uses his talents. And that he's already amazed this new boss coming up. So we pray that he won't get flustered, but he'll be able to handle whatever's before him. So, Lord, we just pray for peace as well for him as he gets prepared to go on a journey. What a journey. So we'll be praying for you, too, when you're not here. Okay. I think it, oh, my. A lot of needs. That's good.
No, you know what? It's the Lord placed on my heart. What's your name, young man?
Micah?
I had a son, Micah. I got a son, Micah. He wants me to tell you, this is very a strong urge from him, that he doesn't see anything in you to rebuke. He loves everything about you.
Praise the Lord.
He wanted me to say this because he wants to honor you, and I'd like to go over there and lay my hands, and maybe a couple other people. We used to do a beehive.
Oh,
a beehive on Micah. Yeah, pretty good. What else? And thank you, Father God. We thank you. Thank you for this one, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that he has a heart for expressly for you, Lord. And you know all this. You know all this. You have numbered everything. And you know his going out and his coming forth and his rising up and his sitting down. And you know when he's sad and you lift him up, Father God. So we thank you for just a new revelation to come upon Micah. Father God, that he is your servant. He is a man of faith. Lord, continue to touch him and keep him close. Keep him, Father God, as the apple of your eye, we ask. In Jesus' precious name.
Amen, brother.
Comes out of your mouth.
Yes,
sir. And don't understand that you're a real worshiper, you're a real praiser, you love the Lord. Love the Lord, and he loves you.
You
are a blessing to us. Thank you for coming.
Yes, we have been behind a long time.
Okay. What's more important than prayer? We don't run on a schedule here. The Holy Spirit takes care of our schedule. We're going to welcome in the Shabbat with the blowing of the shofar. But before we do that, let's say the prayer for the blowing of the shofar.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kishranu anytime Yeshua HaMashiach v'tivrano v'shemah kol shofar amen.
Blessed are you, O Lord God, King of the universe, who sanctified us with the blood of Yeshua the Messiah, and has commanded us to hear the call of the shofar.
Amen.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kivishanu mimitzvotav v'tzivanu lehiyot or le'elgoim v'netzalanu et Yeshua Meshianu haolam. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who sanctified us with your commandments and commanded us to be a light to the nations and gave us Yeshua our Messiah, the light of the world. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Mike will lead us in the Shema.
Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem Kavod, Malchuto, Le'olam Vaed.
Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Blessed be his glorious name, whose kingdom is forever and ever. Amen.
What happened to you?
I went down one there.
There we go.
V'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha v'kol avodecha uv'kol nafshecha uv'kol me'odecha v'hayu hadvarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzvacha hayom avodecha Vishnantam Levaneka Vidavarka Bam Bishitka Bevitheka Ulekha Vaderek Ushokha Ukumeka Ukshakam Lepok Avyadeka Vehayu Letokho Benedetta, Uchatam, Amusopeta, Uvishareta. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. These words that I command you to say shall be on your heart. And you shall teach them to your children, to speak of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you rise up. You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and to be frontless between your eyes, and you shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. Ve'ahavta l'recha kamocha. And you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Upon these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Amen. Here we go. Ready?
Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom. Shabbat, 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 Shalom. Hey! Shabbat, Shalom. Shabbat, Shalom. Shabbat, 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 Shalom. Shabbat, Shabbat. Shabbat, Shabbat, Shalom. Shabbat, Shabbat. Shabbat, Shabbat, Shalom. Shabbat, Shalom. Shabbat, Shalom. Shabbat, 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 Shalom. Hey!
And now we have the prayer before the dwelling. Baruch Adonai Amborach, Baruch Adonai Amborach Le'olam Vaed, Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Amim, V'tan Lan V'et Torto, Baruch Adonai. No tame Adorah. Amen. Bless the Lord who is blessed. Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe, who has chosen us from among the peoples and has given us the Torah. Blessed are you, Adonai, giver of the Torah. Now it gives me pleasure. For Susie, you're doing the doing it this week.
Tom.
Oh, Tom! No.
Oh, it's Mike.
Mike!
I think you asked me. I studied for it, so I
don't say Mike.
Yes, I mean, one or another. I can go around the world.
Oh, I'm going to get somebody else a chance.
No, I'm anxious to know what you have to say, Mr.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, man. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
This is a really, awesome because this is really, we just said, Notein HaTorah, giver of the Torah. Well, this is going to be about Moses, God giving Moses the Torah. So, the parasha and the Torah portion is Exodus 18 to 20, 23. And the word here is Yitro, which means Jethro. So there's really no other meaning that I know of. But you'll hear about Jethro in a minute. And it starts out by saying, now Jethro, the priest of Midian, Moses' father-in-law, heard about all that God had done for Moses and for Israel, his people. So Jethro says to Moses, he is coming to meet Moses, and he is bringing his wife, Moses' wife, Zipporah, and Moses' two sons. And when they meet Moses, Moses tells Jethro of all the things that happened during the stay in Egypt and all that the Lord did to Pharaoh and how the Lord delivered them. So when Jethro hears this, he blesses the Lord, and he makes a sacrifice and burnt offerings. And I'm just thinking, you know, even Moses had had a mentor, his father-in-law. The Lord brought Jethro to bless him. So even the great men of God need we need help too. We need others to come in. Let's see. And so the next day, Moses was judging all the people, and Moses was he was up from morning to night. Kind of like Judge Judy, but only a little bit more, you know. But anyway, Jethro sees this, his father-in-law, and see he has the wisdom of God, and he counseled Moses to delegate most of the small matters to the appointed rulers that he will pick out, and then Moses can deal with the hard ones. So we see here that we need help, and we cannot do all things that God has for us, for we need each other working together, is one of the things I got out of that. Chapter 19, now it's been about 7 weeks since they crossed over the Red Sea, and they camped. And now I'm visualizing, I'm reading this, and I'm visualizing, you know, this has really happened. I mean, we think it's like a fairy tale because it's like 3,000-4,000 years ago, but this stuff really happened. So I started putting myself in their place. And it's pretty amazing. 7 weeks they crossed over from the Red Sea, and they camped at Mount Sinai in the desert. I can only imagine how the people felt seeing God opening up the Red Sea and then closing it on the Egyptian army. Now they're camped at this mountain in the desert. Moses is called to God, and he is to tell the people, you have seen what I did to the Egyptians and how I bore you on eagle's wings and brought you to myself. That is a love story. Now, if you will indeed obey my voice and keep my covenant, then you shall be a special treasure to me above all peoples, Jewish people. And you shall be to me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. And see, this is the covenant that God, you know, he's bringing all this to happen so he can make them his special people. And then the Lord tells Moses then to tell the people, and Israel accepts the covenant that God has offered them. So we see here that Israel accepts the covenant, and here we see such a beautiful picture of how God chose Israel, delivered Israel from sin, Egypt, gave them his covenant, and they are God's special treasure. Now, in the same thing as people, we're the church. And in the Brit Hadashah it says, we are holy nation, we are a special people, we are priests. And so we have the same, you know, we have the same covenant, only actually better. Okay, the Lord then sanctifies Israel and brings them to the base of Mount Sinai. And Moses goes up and receives the law, the Ten Commandments, and brings it down to Israel. The Lord, being so majestic and actually terrifying, they ask Moses to speak to them, not God, lest we die. The last verse, God says that we are to have no other gods or make any idols which are useless, even jealous God. Okay, the half Torah, Isaiah 6:1. Here we see the call of God to Isaiah. He sees him seated on his throne, eyes lifted up, seraphim, which I did a little research, I discovered are created to serve and to worship God around his throne. They have six wings. Each set of their wings serves a different purpose. One set covers the face, denoting holy reverence and awe, and acts as protection from the radiance of God. Another set of wings is used for flying to aid in the swift servitude for God. And the third set of wings is used to cover their feet so that they can humbly conceal their unworthiness when they're in God's holy presence. When Isaiah sees God's holiness, he realizes how unclean he is, and the seraphim takes the tongs and brings the fiery coal and touches the lips to cleanse him. Then he hears the Lord say, "Whom shall I send? Who will go for us?" Which I love because it means Father, Son, and Holy Spirit are mentioned here. And I love that one. It said, "Let us make man in our image." Who will go before us? That's Shalosh Echad. Three and one. The Brit Hadisha, Matthew 19:16-26. This tells the story of the rich young ruler who finds out that he has done everything right. But Jesus says, "Hey, one thing you lack, and one thing you're in need of. Sell all that you have and follow me." Well, he went away sad. We don't know when he might come back. I think maybe he got some repentance. I don't know. Hopefully. This shows me that, you know, to be a disciple, to be chosen, it means it will cost us everything that keeps us from serving Jesus 100%. And that's it.
Hey! Robin, what's your best?
You know, that scene of seeing the Lord seated on the throne, how many of you know that song? I see the Lord seated on his throne, and the train of his robe fills the church with glory.
And the whole earth is filled.
And the
whole earth is filled.
And the whole earth is filled. With this
Baruch
Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Natan Lanu Et Torah Emet V'Chayei Olam Nata Bichukenu Baruch Adonai Noteinu Torah. King of the universe, who has given us the Torah of truth and planted within us eternal life. Blessed are you, Adonai, giver of the Torah. Amen. All right. And now, if you want to get the song ready, do you want to play it yet? At the beginning?
Not yet.
She's here. Give her a stand up for this gal. I don't know what I would do without her.
I guess.
She's so precious to all of us. So very, very precious. And I want to thank Mike for keeping us posted almost second by second so we knew exactly how to pray for this one. Okay.
Okay.
That's enough of that.
Enough already.
Enough about you, what about me? Nope.
Yeah, right.
Shabbat Shalom, everyone.
Shabbat Shalom.
I first want to say, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart, Lord, be acceptable to you.
Amen. Amen to that.
This evening I want to share an experience with you. It's my experience, but in the telling of it, the testimony belongs to God. This is a testimony of a loving, faithful, gracious, healing God. And tonight in the parasha, when Mike was reading from Exodus, that's a testimony of God right there. What he did, he took them through the Red Sea. You know, he brought them out. Here's the thing about when we hear God's testimony, let us be moved by it and really be mindful of who he is. For me, the best way to start this testimony is to praise him.
Yes.
And so there's a song that I've been listening to. It's by a wonderful chorist. It's Elevation. I don't know if any of you know Elevation music, but it's powerful. And so we're going to hear this time of worship, and then I'll get into telling God.
Faithfulness, faithfulness.
Michael, I don't feel good, honey.
and it kept getting worse and worse. And I said, Michael, call the ambulance. I think I must have shook my husband up because he's like going back and forth. And I said, honey, did you call the ambulance? He goes, I can't find the number. It's 911, sweetheart. So there I am. I'm trying to get ready because I know I'm going to the hospital. And my stomach was upset, and I'm on the throne. And who comes in but two sheriffs before the EMTs. They come in the bathroom, and they said, ma'am, how you doing? I go, I can't breathe. And I'm thinking, get the heck out of here, please. I'm not in a way that you should be here. So they kept saying, you're going to be fine, you're going to be fine. And then the EMTs came. And I literally could not breathe. And they put a CPAP on me, so the air was being forced. Put me in the ambulance and sent me with sirens blaring to the hospital. Got to the hospital. There is an army of doctors and nurses greeting me. And they bring me in, they start doing all tests. They do a blood workup, and it shows if you had a heart attack. There's an enzyme called troponin that if you've had a heart attack, your body produces it. So they came in, they said, you've had a heart attack, we're admitting you. Let me emphasize this right now. It seems like, oh my gosh, you had a heart attack, but you know what? God had to put me in the hospital. He had to set up the situation for him to show himself mighty.
Amen to that.
Thank you, brother. And so that was the second. On the third, they went and they did an angiogram. I'd had a heart attack before and they had put a stent in. They said, everything is fine. There's no blockages. Everything is fine. But I was still in the ICU. And the morning of the 4th, my husband is in the room with me, and he said he saw me with my eyes rolled back, slumping down. And then 15 people came running in, they shook him out, and I was clinically dead. My heart had stopped, and I was clinically dead. There was no breath, there was no life. And so they did what they do best. They did CPR. That wasn't working, so they did the electric paddles. And people have asked me, did you have an out-of-body experience? No, I did not. I didn't see the light. I didn't hear anybody say or singing, no. It was, I mean, when I came to, it's like where I was confused. Where am I? What's happening? Why are you on top of me? It's like, so then they, back into the ICU, and it was at that time they told me what happened. The realization of my God became so real to me at that time. I want to tell you, there were times in my life when I was always striving to make myself better, because my past, I gotta tell you, I was a bad girl. You know, they say there's a season of sin and there's pleasure. Well, that season ends. Let me just share that with you. And thank God got a hold of me. But I was striving all the time, trying to do what I could do to be better. And I want to backtrack a little bit. In November, I cried out to God. I said, God, you've got to do something. You've got to help me. And the Lord showed me a scripture in Psalms. And I want to read it to you. And when I read it to you, you're going to see how absolutely wonderful and powerful he is. And of course, everything's out of order here because I dropped my pages. So, what the heck? Psalm 107 in its verses 19 to 20. So I pray that you hear these words, but let them really get into your heart. And then they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them from their distress. He sent out his word and healed them. And he rescued them from the grave. Do you understand how God's word is so precise? I'm praying this before any of this other stuff had happened. And another scripture is out of 2 Samuel. They confronted me in the day of my disaster, but the Lord, here we go, his testimony, but the Lord was my support. He brought me out into a spacious place, and he rescued me because he delighted in me. The understanding of God's love became so real to me, and it didn't have anything to do with striving and trying to be better, to earn his love. Let me say to each and every one of you, God loves you right now, where you at. You don't have to change. He just loves you. And he will always love you. You can mess up, and he's still going to love you. Mm-hmm. So here I am, this understanding of who God is. And there's a scripture in Romans, and I'm trying to find it, that talks about striving. And Paul's talking about you can't, it's God's grace that he gives you. You can't be trying to do works, because if you're doing works, you're not going to receive the grace. That really struck me. God, I don't have to be running around trying to, you know, be on this team and serve on this cabinet and just doing all this stuff, reading my, you know, reading my Bible every day. You'll like me more. No. He loves you just the way you are. And I was in the hospital for 8 days. And on the 7th day, I woke up early. If you've ever been in the cardiac ward of Eisenhower Hospital, it's on the 4th floor. And they had these huge windows, so in every room has this beautiful view. And I looked out, and the dawn was pink. I saw it tonight, and I go, God, thank you. It was another reassurance that I got your back. And I looked out. The mountain was all covered in pink. And the flagpole at Eisenhower, well, there wasn't any flag on it. It was just the pole. And it's this bright pink. And it was like an explanation point. And I heard in my spirit, daughter, I love you. And I have a purpose for you. I'm with you. I was overwhelmed by the thought of God's unconditional love for me. Overwhelmed with it. And then the next day, the 8th day, Fran calls me in the morning. She goes, have you seen the rainbow? No, let me go look. And I looked out, and there was this rainbow that was so pristine. The colors were so vivid and bright. And once again, I hear in my spirit, God says, for I know the plans I have for you. Plans for a hope and a future, and not to bring calamity. What was so meaningful for me for that, hearing that in my spirit, was when I became a new Christian, that was the verse that God said, this is your life verse. So once again, he's reassuring me. And when I say I've changed, I have. my thinking is, I am so secure in His love. I am so confident that God loves me just the way I am. I don't have to do anything special. He just loves me. And one of the points that I want to make really clear to you tonight, it's not because God loves me more. No. He loves us all the same. What He did for me, He can do for you. So understand that your prayers go up to the Father. Yeshua is working. He's our advocate. He is working on our behalf all the time. So I thank you guys for so much for your prayers. They were so effective. They made a dent, a big dent, because they're so real. So if you ever get the thought in your head, oh, I don't know if I pray, if it's gonna, God's gonna listen to me. No, He listens to you. And tonight when the shofar blew, someone had told me, when the shofar blows, the angels are put at attention. I don't know if you know it, but they are waiting. We have angels around us. We actually have guardian angels. And they are waiting to be discharged. They're waiting to help us. The Word of God says that they are there to help us. So much so that if we stumble, we won't even stub our toe. So I love you guys so much. I am so blessed that I'm here. I want to say, if any of you have any issues with your heart, I want to pray for you tonight. Not that I'm anything special, but I think there's an anointing here because of God's work and His healing. So if any of you have any issues with your heart, I would love to pray for you tonight.
It's not for myself, and my heart is fine, but I know my mother has got a burden, and the doctors are keeping a close eye on her, so yeah, the burden is related to her heart, so prayers for them, please.
What's your mother's name?
Eleanor.
Eleanor, Father, we come to you tonight, Lord. And Lord, this son has cried out to you, Lord. Jeremiah 33 says, call out to me and I will answer you. That's it for sure, guys. And so lift up Eleanor to the Lord in all these issues with her heart, Lord God. Your name is Jehovah Rapha. You are the Lord God who heals. Jesus, you hung on the cross. And when the children were on their 40-year journey, there was an attack of snakes. Mm-hmm. And they made a post with a snake around it. And the Lord said, look unto these and you will be healed. Our sign is Jesus Christ on the cross. So Lord, we lift you tonight. We lift up Eleanor, Lord. We know there's no distance in prayer. Father, where she's at right now, we ask that you would touch her. Lord, bring healing to her heart. Your shalom, Lord, let her rest in the love of you, Lord Jesus. And Lord, we pray expectantly tonight to see how you're going to move your hand. And in all things, we ask in Jesus' precious name, Yeshua's name.
I can take that back.
I have more problems.
Come up here, mister.
Yeah, I have a food also, but today I went for a physical and my blood pressure was increased, my heart rate was increased, so they're going to be monitoring my blood pressure for the next 2 weeks to see where to go. But if I need prayer for my heart.
Lord God, oh Father, you are so wonderful, so awesome. Lord, once again, your word says, call to me and I will answer you. Lord, heart issues, they cause concern. Let me just say it. We get really concerned when it's about our heart. So, Lord, you are the healer of all things, whether it's your heart or your back or whatever. Your name is Jehovah Rapha. So, Lord, tonight for Barry, we love him so much. We know that you love him even more. Lord, we ask that you would bring your peace, your shalom into his body or his heart. Cause that rhythm to come into perfect pace, Lord, that he's not going to go into AFib or any racing of his heart. Blood pressure come down right now in the name of Jesus. We tell you right now to come into a normal range. Lord, once again, we ask for your shalom, your peace in this body. And Lord, this heart, which is so important to all of our beings, Lord, you bring it into perfect rhythm. Right now, in the name of Jesus, we tell you, heart, come into perfect rhythm. No exciting beats or beats that are missed. No, none of that, Lord. We ask for perfect rhythm. And once again, we ask in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
No, thank you. Anybody else got some heart issues? Okay.
Arrhythmia.
Oh, God. Yeah. Peace and cake for the Lord. Yeah. Father, we come to you right now, Lord, and you have created us. Lord, your word says you knew where we were being knit in the womb, so you know Linda so personally, so intimately. And Lord, once again, we ask that you, Lord Jesus, would cause his heart to come into a perfect rhythm. No more running fast or running slow, none of that. Just a perfect beat. And Lord, your name is Healer. We call to you tonight. And we know that you answer us because you hear us and you care about us. You love us.
Yes.
So all of us right now are coming in agreement, Lord, have her heart come into perfect rhythm.
Yes,
in the name
of Jesus.
Precious name.
Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Amen, Micah. Do you have a prayer request?
Yes, I
do.
What's your prayer request?
My blood pressure.
Oh, Father, we love you. We know you love us. You love Micah so much, Lord God. And his blood pressure, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
You can cause his blood pressure to come down and come into a perfect range, Lord God. We nothing that we do or say, Lord, is him. Has any power, but it's you, Lord God, that we look to. You're the one that touches Micah's body, Lord. You're the one that brings his blood pressure into a normal range, Lord God. So he's not going to have it too high or too low. It's going to be perfect. And Lord, we know that you hear us. We know that you respond to prayer, Lord. So right now, Micah, God is bringing your rhythm into and your blood pressure into perfect range. And once again, we ask in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I don't know, the chest pain and all that, and it's making me scared and kind of.
Okay, Lord, we ask for any anxious thoughts, any episodes of anxiety, Lord, that are causing pain in your chest, Lord. We ask for your shalom, Lord, right now to endow Nina. Lord, bring her to a place where she feels your shalom, your peace, your comfort, Lord. And Lord, that she will be able to sit and just relax and experience your peace, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Once again, we're all praying in agreement, Lord. Your peace is going to just flood her being right now, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Bring her into that place of shalom.
Yes.
Yes, Lord God. We praise you and bless you.
I want to pray for someone. Actually, I just saw on Facebook. He's a former crush I had.
His mom is like my spiritual mom, so we have a beautiful relationship. But anyways, he had heart surgery about a year ago, and he's a hard worker. He's a construction worker, and he has some pride because it got in the way of the quality of his work. And so he had to admit that because he was working really hard, working really fast, but it wasn't showing forth in the quality of his work. So I just want to say on behalf of my brother, he's brother now of mine, a friend, and that God would just heal him. And just, you know, why not?
Listen, if he can open up the Red Sea, come on.
Because he does good work, you know?
Does.
God creates in his image.
That's right.
We are his workmanship.
And we're all coming in agreement.
Yes.
Right now.
For David, his name is David.
David?
Yes, I know.
And Lord, we ask once again, Lord, that your shalom would come over him, Lord. Not only would it come over him, Lord, but it would cause him to relax.
Yes.
To be at peace.
Yes.
And Lord, in those quiet times, if you will speak to him.
Yes.
Lord, he loves you.
Yes.
Speak to him, Lord, if you love him. You love him.
Amen.
And he will feel your unconditional love. And your peace, Lord.
So, because my English is not better, God
God is the truth. God is the mercy.
Yeah.
So we are needed for everybody, not just family. We are belong to God. So, so we are is the one belong to Jesus. So we are just God is good. God is making use. God is good.
Long live God Almighty. Hallelujah.
Right. And I will sing this song. Jesus love you, and you just worship God, and just worship God. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
She just develops called achalasia,
She cannot swallow from the esophagus to the stomach. And they said it's an immune disease. She's very young. She's 61. And she's having a surgery. And they have been postponing this in Mexico City 3 times. So she's having it done in April. And I just pray that the Lord will open up the esophagus so she can eat. She has lost about 50 pounds.
How is she eating? How is she
is swallowing. The swallow is so slow, and it's very hard for her. Mm-hmm. Sometimes she chokes because she cannot swallow. The food goes here, but it cannot go through the stomach. So it's very hard. I also have high blood pressure, and there's a lot of high blood pressure here. And anyways, I'm just going to see the doctor Tuesday, and I'm just praying for good rhythm in our hearts. And I know there's a healing anointing here for everyone. And there's prayers that are tugging our hearts that we know of family members of ourselves. And sometimes we keep quiet, but the Lord says, speak out.
Amen. Amen to that.
Absolutely, yes. Absolutely. I'm going to give another testimony to God right now.
Yes.
It's his testimony. I had a growth on my left breast, and it was big. And they were going to do surgery. And the day of the surgery, I'm in there. They put, you know, the IV in. The anesthesiologist came in and said, this is what we're going to do. You'll probably be up for so long and blah, blah, blah. And then the doctor came in, and they will mark where the tumor is with a little black pen. And the doctor went, I'm not feeling anything. He said, I cannot operate on you when there's nothing to operate on. Once again, this was the effect of prayer, unified prayer going before me.
Amen.
If God can do it for me, he can do it for you.
Yes. Absolutely.
So Father, we come before you. This is a daughter who loves her mom. And Lord, she's concerned about her health. A sister who's concerned about her sister and about this surgery. Lord, we ask that you would move your hand. Lord, there is no distance in prayer. We already know that. So Lord, go to where these women are, Lord God, and by your spirit and by your anointing, Lord God, whatever is troubling them, whatever is causing them pain, Lord God, we pray that you would move a mighty hand, Lord God, and bring health and healing and well-being to these women. And Lord, once again, that her sister, if she goes in for surgery, they're going to say, there's nothing there we can't offer.
Yes.
So we're believing, Lord, for miracles. You are the miracle worker.
Yes.
There's a song, a praise song that says, Waymaker.
Yeah.
We're a miracle worker. Yes. Light in the dark.
Yes.
And that's what you are, Lord God.
Yes.
And Lord, for this blood pressure, Lord, we come together asking, Lord God, you bring this blood pressure into perfect alignment with your body that is not high, Lord God. We're not dictating to how you're going to heal her, Lord. We're giving you free range, however you want to do it, Lord. And we thank you tonight, Lord God. And we are expectant in our prayers. In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So I just want to share this one prayer with you. And it comes out of Romans. It's scripture. Romans 11:6. And it says, and it's Paul speaking. And if by grace, then it can't be based on works. It's got to be based on grace, not by works. If it were based on works, grace would no longer be grace. And this is my thought about this. My whole concept of grace was totally wrong. Intellectually, I knew grace. I knew that we are saved by grace. But then I was always trying to perfect myself by my own effort.
can't do it. When we try to do it in our own strength, in our own effort, we fall short. By God.
By God.
By God. I'm here to give testimony to my Father in heaven, to Yeshua, my Lord, and to the Holy Spirit who brings anointing of healing. So we bless you tonight, Lord. We praise you. We just acknowledge your wonderfulness, Lord. And we thank you, Lord. We come with grateful hearts. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
We really have a vein tonight with so many people. We don't talk about it, we keep it secret, whatever, but this was really needed tonight, you know. I've known you a long time. I didn't know you had, you know, that issue, but it's important to bring it to the surface so we can pray for each other. That's what it's all about, is corporate prayer. Great message, my friend.
Yes.
But the first thing is that you're here to tell it. Amen. What a message. Thank you. I love you. Get over here. Thank you. Thank you for sharing.
Oh, yeah, yes.
Okay, so announcements. Tomorrow starts the Bar Mitzvah class. I'm hoping that the Bar Mitzvah boy will be ready for the class. And also tomorrow you saw Ronnie Mercier, you know Ronnie from Olam. He was a drummer in the Birds and
guess who?
Traveled with him. Anyway, it's his memorial service tomorrow here at 4, if you would like to come and
hear. Here.
Yeah, tomorrow at 4. And Ronnie played drums for a long time at Ohav, and also there was a church on Washington, yeah, that he played drums at. So come and join us, celebrate a life well lived tomorrow at 4. And then we're going to have a Purim party. We're going to celebrate what Esther did for our people, right? Without Esther, I wouldn't be here talking. So we're going to have an original play, and hopefully Connie and Mitch will feel up to the task to be doing it with Barry and I. And so we'll have Humantashen, and we'll celebrate for a time such as this. And you people are needed. Every single one of you has a job before you that has this blood pressure problem or heart failure. You've got work to do. You've got work to do. She's got work to do. We can't afford to lose you, amen? So also right around the corner for that, and I'm going to pass this around, is the list for Passover. That's going to be Friday, the 7th of April, and we already got Les Yakov. He's got a table for 10 already. So get your sign up for it. I'm going to pass it around. Would you mind passing that? So there's a lot going on at the end of this month. Yeah. When is it? March. I have it in my announcements, but my slide is so messed up you can't read it. But I will get it out to you. It's in March. Sometime in March. Coming up soon. And then right behind that, like I say, is Passover. So yeah, if you want to, and Susie Lynette is going to be doing Passover this year. We're trying something different. She's such a marvelous teacher. And so I'm anxious to see, you know, how she does it, what she does. So please sign up and let me know. We don't have a price yet, but we try to keep the price down, and a lot depends upon the caterer, and hopefully, you know, with the cost of food going up, hopefully we can still keep the price down. So we encourage you to join us. It's always a very festive time. And those of you that would like to dance with Barbara and I, we'll be starting rehearsals for that, because we start off the whole shebang by ushering in the Holy Spirit through dance and worship. Amen? So it should be a wonderful, wonderful time. We hope you'll join us for that. Barry, is there anything else?
Mm-hmm. Can we have to do...
Yes. Do you want to come up, Mike, and we'll do the sacraments? Yeah, it's interesting. Each one of you have jobs. We all have work to do. You know, there's still unsafe people. We all have work to do. So God, keep your soldiers working.
Good words, Andy. Good to have you.
Thanks.
Yeah, it's great to see you. I feel the feeling here tonight.
Mm-hmm.
In so many ways. And this is another part of it. You know, every time I've been hearing people say the more you take communion, the better off you're going to be. Actually, it brings more
healing.
Yeah. Because we're partaking of the body and the blood.
By his stripes, we are healed.
That's right.
That's right.
Amen. Hallelujah. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamokseh lechem min haaretz. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe, who bring forth bread from the earth. And Lord, we thank you that you gave your body the bread of life, to let us eat now. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei pri adamin. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe, who brings forth fruit from the vine. And Lord, we thank you that you are the vine and we're the branches, and we get to partake of your precious blood. Let's drink it now.
To life.
If everybody can stand, please.
V'yerech Adonai v'yishmarech. Yisadonai benevolecha v'chuleika. Yisadonai benevolecha v'yasem icha. Shalom. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face smile down upon you and be gracious unto you. May he lift up his countenance upon you and grant you peace. In the name of our Prince of Peace, our Sar Shalom, Yeshua HaMashiach, be blessed.
Amen.
Ooh.
Let's all put more.